Some of you guys may not like this example because we use the zero for the base already, so it's kind of like cheating. This is the video that I really wanted to make since 2017. Today, I will give you guys a legitimate example of a limit with the indeterminate form 0 to the 0th power, and the answer is 0. I finally came up with an example after so many years. Have a look right here. I have this for you guys. The limit as x approaching not 0, but rather infinity. And then for the base, I have to make it 0, right? And the way I do it is square root of x plus 1 minus square root of x. I will verify that this is legitimately equal to 0 later, don't worry. And then I also have to have a power that's approaching 0. And my choice is 1 over ln, not just x, but rather ln of x. And you might be wondering why. Well, I put 1 over ln x, and then the answer is 1. So I tried it with 1 over ln of ln x, and it worked. And I was so happy. Okay. I feel so emotional anyway. Let me just go ahead and verify the inside for you guys first. Put infinity into all that, right? So let me just do that on the side here. So this is the inside of poor little star. When x is approaching infinity of square root of x plus 1 minus square root of x. Well, if x is approaching infinity, this is going to be approaching infinity. Minus, this will also be approaching infinity. But when we have infinity minus infinity, we cannot say that's approaching 0. It's an indeterminate form. Right, the cat will be sad if you just write down 0 and then without showing work. Well, another thing that you can do is if you try the limit as x approaching infinity of square root of 2x plus 1 minus square root of x, then you will really see that infinity minus infinity, you don't end up with 0 all the time. So be careful with that. But anyway, I will show you guys this legitimately. To do so, I will just multiply the top and bottom by the conjugate, which is just the square root of x plus 1 plus square root of x, and then divide it by that right away here. By the way, let me know what the answer is. Okay, so right here, we are going to get the limit as x approaching infinity. On the top, we just have to square this, which will just get x plus 1, and then minus the square of that, which is just x. And on the bottom, we just have that. Square root of x plus 1 plus square root of x. But as you can see, x minus x cancel, so we just have a 1 on the top. And then when x is approaching infinity, here we get infinity plus infinity. Infinity plus infinity is just a bigger infinity, but still infinity. So we just have 1 over infinity, then we can conclude that that is equal to 0. Alright? But if you have a 2, it's a different story. Go ahead and try, seriously. Now, for the exponent, if we have the limit as x approaching infinity of 1 over ln of x, well, put infinity to here, we get 1 over ln of infinity. Ln of infinity is infinity. It's always increasing without horizontal asymptote. So we get 1 over ln, that is just infinity. But ln of infinity, it's infinity, we just talk about it. So it's 1 over infinity, and 1 over infinity will give us 0. So this right here is also 0. So this condition satisfied. Now, we just have to do this limit, and hopefully the answer is indeed equal to 0, and I'll have complete all the examples for you guys, right? 0 to a 0 can be approaching 1. 0 to the 0 can be approaching a number bigger than 1 or any other number, and it can also approach 0 now. But anyway, let's go ahead and do this. How do we do it? Notice we have a function to a function power, and I think the following way is easier. I'm going to set this to be a number that say L, and I will take natural log on both sides. You can also write the base as e to the ln of that. But I think the writing is going to be not that pretty. This was easier. Set this to be L and then take natural log on both sides. Why? Let me write this down right here first. Ln of L, this right here is equal to this, right? Here's the deal. Natural log is a continuous function when x is greater than 0. The natural log of a limit, it's a limit of the natural log we can switch the order. So I can just take a look at the limit as x approaching infinity of ln of this thing, which is the square root of x plus 1 minus square root of x, this raised to the 1 over ln of x power, like so. And now, thanks to the natural log, we can take this and then put it in the front as a multiplication. So this becomes the limit as x approaching infinity. And here's the deal. This right here, I will just write it down on the numerator, ln of square root of x plus 1 minus square root of x. And then it's a fraction, so I will just put this down the bottom, which is ln of x. Yay. Now, let me tell you, if we put infinity into all the x's, this right here is technically 0 plus, so we end up with ln of 0 plus, which will give us negative infinity. And then when we put infinity here, we will just get infinity per our discussion earlier. So this is an infinity over infinity situation. The negative doesn't matter. The key is we can use L'Hopital's rule. So I'm just going to tell you we can use L'Hopital's rule because of infinity over infinity. So I'll just put this down right here. So here we go. Let's go ahead and differentiate the top and then differentiate the bottom, right? And then we are looking at the limit as x approaching infinity. All right, differentiating this, we will just first do 1 over that. So it's 1 over square root of x plus 1 minus square root of x. And then we are going to multiply by the derivative inside. Chain rule. So here we go. The derivative of the square root is 1 over 2 square root of the inside. And the derivative of the inside here is just 1, so it doesn't matter anymore. And then minus the derivative of the square root here is 1 over 2 square root of x. And then for the bottom, ln of that, right? So ln of a box like this. Differentiating this ln, we have 1 over this thing. And then the derivative of ln of x is 1 over x. So multiply by 1 over x, which is the same as multiply by the x right here. So that's what we have. Now, if you put infinity into all the x's, it will be horrendous. So don't do it like that. Try to simplify a few things before you do another derivative. So the way I'm going to do it is, I'm going to bring this up to here. It's multiplying the top and bottom by the denominator. And then in the meantime, I'll also clean this up. Let me show you. This becomes the limit as x approaching infinity. So as I said, I will multiply x ln x here and then x ln x so that this and that cancel completely. Put this right there. So we have x ln x over that square root of x plus 1 minus square root of x. And then for this, let's just get the common denominator. So for this one, I need a square root. Multiply the top and bottom by the square root of x. Right, so multiply this by square root of x, multiply that by square root of x. So for the first one, we will have, actually, let me just do it like this. And then right here, I will multiply by square root of x plus 1, square root of x plus 1. Right? Now they have the same denominator. I will just write this down. We have the following. Parentheses, the denominator is 2 square root of x plus 1 times square root of x. And then for the numerator, we have square root of x minus square root of x plus 1. Cool. You know what's even better? This and that are almost the same, but different order. So what do we do? Don't worry. Let's just switch the order of subtraction by factoring out negative. So this is negative parentheses square root x plus 1 and then minus square root of x. And then be happy. Because now, this and that, bye-bye. Now what though, huh? So, wow, let's see if I can finish everything here. I'm just gonna put this and that together. We have, this is the limit as x approaching infinity. Now, check this out. I am going to look at the square, the x and also the square root of x. We can reduce that. this is x to the first power, this is x to the 1/2 power, subtract the exponent, 1 minus 1/2 is 1/2. This over that, we have square root of x, okay? And then we still have that ln x. Over, we still have this on the bottom, 2 square root of x plus 1. Now what? L'Hopital's rule? No need. Check this out. Here we have a limit of a product. It's the same as the product of the limit, provided if they all exist. I'm going to break this apart as follows. I will first take a look at the limit as x approaching infinity of the square root of x over that 2 square root of x plus 1, and then times the limit as x approaching infinity of ln x. I know what you guys are thinking. I just thought about it too. I forgot the negative. This negative, oh my god, it's right here, which I would not somehow erase it. Alright, I have to have a negative here, so I will have a negative here, right? So sorry, so just take a look again. Okay, cool. Now, I will do this the lazy way. When x is approaching infinity, the plus 1 doesn't matter. It's really just this over that. So the first limit in blue is really just 1/2, alright? So this is negative, and we have 1/2. And then this right here, the limit as x approaching infinity of ln x, that will give us infinity. So altogether, in fact, negative 1/2 times infinity, we end up with negative infinity. Oh my god, check this out. What we are saying is ln of l, which is what we are trying to get, is equal to negative infinity. So right here, ln of l, let me just write this down, ln of l, it's equal to negative infinity. I don't care about ln. I don't want the ln here. I do care about ln, but I don't want the ln here. What do? Do e to the power and e to the power cancel them out. Ladies and gentlemen, we will end up with l, which is, oh my god, the limit that I got for you guys today. The limit as x approaching infinity, square root of x plus 1 minus square root of x raised to the 1 over ln of x. What's e to the negative infinity? 1 over e to the infinity. E to the infinity is 0. No, e to the infinity is infinity. This is 1 over infinity. I don't... Yeah, just 0. This right here, it's equal to 0. Whew! Oh my god. Finally. After many, many years, I finally came up with an example that 0 to 0's power is equal to... Well, it's approaching zero with the limit right here. And you might be wondering how I got it. I'll talk about this real quick. I thought about, in order for this to approach zero, the base has to be very, very small, right? It's like a very small zero. So this and that, they are actually really, really close. So that's how I got this idea, right? Square root of x plus 1 plus minus x. When x is approaching infinity, they're tiny. Yeah, so small. Meanwhile, for the exponent, I want it to be a very, very, well, a bigger zero. What do I mean? Here's the deal. If you guys have seen my other videos, then you know what I'm talking about. Here I have a list, right? We have ln of x. This is the smallest kind of infinity, which is less than x to the p's power, and then it's less than b to the x, it's less than x to the x, right? So I will just say as x goes to infinity, p has to be greater than 0, b has to be greater than 1. So p greater than 0, b greater than 1. This is the smallest infinity. If I do the reciprocal, in fact, this turns out to be the biggest zero among all this. So let me show you. We get 1 over ln x becomes greater than 1 over x to the p, and so on. Because I just stopped you right here. Yeah? Anyway though, this right here, it's like the biggest zero. But as I told you guys earlier, if I only have 1 over ln of x, that was still not enough. So to make this even bigger, I put on another one. And it worked.